Back in 2015, I wrote a short Python script to automatically replace the features on an image of a face with the features from a second image of a face. In other words, face swapping. By leveraging some heavyweight libraries, the final script weighs in at around 90 lines. In this video, I'll explain how I did it. The first step is to load the input images. We use OpenCV to do this, and we'll be using it later on too. The first image loaded is the face image. This is the image containing the face that will be put on the other image. The second image loaded is the body image. This is the image containing the face which will be replaced with the other face. Next, we extract landmarks from the input faces. A facial landmark corresponds with a particular point on a person's face, for example, the corner of the eye or the mouth. To do this, the script uses dlib, a third-party library which extracts 68 landmarks. The algorithm it uses to extract the landmarks is very complex, but dlib's interface for using it is incredibly simple. The function getLandmarks takes an image in the form of a NumPy array and returns a 68x2 element array, each row of which corresponds with the x, y coordinates of a particular landmark in the input image. The feature extractor, or predictor, requires a rough bounding box as input to the algorithm. This is provided by a face detector, which returns a list of rectangles, each of which corresponds with a face in the image. To make the predictor, a pre-trained model is required. Such a model can be downloaded from the dlib website. At this point, we have our two landmark arrays, each row having coordinates to a particular facial feature. For example, the 30th row gives the coordinates of the tip of the nose. We're now going to rotate, translate, and scale the landmarks of the face image such that they fit as closely as possible to the landmarks in the body image. The idea being that the same transformation can be used to overlay the face image over the body image. It turns out this sort of problem can be solved with what is known as an ordinary Procrustes analysis, which I've implemented in a function called transformation from points. This function breaks down into three parts. At the start, the center of mass is subtracted to locate each group of points at the origin. Next, the points are scaled according to the standard deviation of the points so that the faces are the same size. Finally, a mathematical tool known as the singular value decomposition is used to get the rotation that best matches these scaled and translated points on top of each other. With this information, we can derive a transformation that maps the points of one of the images onto the other. This transformation is plugged into OpenCV's warp affine function to line up the face image with the body image. Next, we need to decide which parts of the image shall be visible. To do this, a mask, known in the film industry as a matte, is used. This is a black and white image, where white corresponds with areas where the face image is visible, and black corresponds with areas where the body image is visible. The mask that I used consists of two parts, a convex polygon covering the eyes and the brows, and a convex polygon covering the nose and the mouth. The points bounded by each polygon are defined by indices into the landmark points. For each part, we start by using OpenCV's convex hull function to draw a white polygon around each of the groups. To add a little padding, the mask is expanded by a few pixels. Finally, the mask is blurred so that there is a smooth graduation between the two images. The blur amount is proportional to the face's size so that the same constants can be used regardless of the input image. When the mask is applied, this is the result. It's good, but not completely convincing. The issue is that the colours are mismatched due to variations in skin tone and in lighting. To correct this, I implemented a function called correctColors. This function modifies the face image by retaining the details, that is to say, the high frequency components from the face image, and taking everything else, that is to say, the low frequency components from the body image. The idea is that the details will capture the parts that we recognize as facial features, and the rest represents skin tone and lighting. The low frequency component of the body image is obtained by blurring, and the high frequency component of the face image is obtained by subtracting a blurred face image from the original face image. When blended with the body image using the mask, this is the result. This is a fairly crude solution to the problem, and an appropriate size blur is key. Too small, and facial features from the first image will show up in the second. Too large, and the kernel strays outside of the face area, and discoloration occurs. While this method doesn't compare to more modern approaches such as deepfakes, I think it still holds up pretty well considering its simplicity. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe. I'll leave you with a slideshow of other face swaps created with my script.